We're here for round one of a Legacy Daily, and I'm going to be playing first. Alright, so I've made quite a few changes to the deck since I played it last time. I'm actually running Squadron Hawk main. I'm going to keep this hand because there's counters. I can get the GTA out on turn two. I'm not really susceptible to a wasteland. And, like, going into this game pretty much blind, so I wonder, let's see what he's playing. And I can pretty much go turn two GTA misstep. Yeah, that's not staying on the board. No way I'm letting Grim Lavamancer resolve. That's nonsense. Yeah. And at least I have another land, so in case he does try to wasteland or something. If he's playing red and I can get that swing in with the GTA, I'm pretty much set. And oh well, looks like he's probably playing Zoo. Yeah, I think if I counter this Tarmogoyf, I don't have like anything, but I'd have an active GTA, so I'm gonna go for it because like I just can't deal with the Tarmogoyf otherwise. And hopefully I get like a Brainstorm or something. Okay, not horrible by any means. I will probably get a basic. I don't think he'd be playing like super budget, but if I get a Tundra and he does actually have wastelands, that would suck. But I'm gonna wait till his turn. The original Planeswalker. Why is it? There's like a moon in the picture. I'm not sure. Okay, so he's like. Oh, that hurts. On the plus side. So, I'm thinking he doesn't have wastelands, but there's... I don't want to open myself up to a wasteland, though, so I'm going to get the planes. And if he were to... use the Pride Mage there. Okay, dang. So the question is, do I want to... Because I... Let's see. What are my best options here? If he untaps... Well... I can either save my Curse Catcher and have him kill it and then gain 2 life and I still get nowhere because I deal no damage, or I just gain 4 life at some point. And I'm going to play a second Wasteland because I don't think there's much of a difference. So he's going to destroy the GTA, which stinks, but... Yeah, gain 2 life. This was to be expected. I mean, the only difference is that I'd be down 2 life had I done it differently. Which is just bad value. Let's see. What does he have? Chain Lightning kind of sucks, but... Not too worried about that. Alright, Brainstorm into some action, please. Not quite. I think I'll put... Because I don't think there's anything that Daze would actually help with here, so... Daze is definitely going on top. And then we'll put... Swords, because I can just get it with Wasteland. I mean, with the brainstorm. Derp. Take that one. He can kill himself with his own fetches. That stinks. Okay, so Pride Mage is in the way. I mean, I was gonna draw the swords anyway, so. Let's see. Ooh, that is a bit of a beating. I can't cast Jace this turn, so I'm gonna put Daze again on top and keep Jace there. And let's see. I'm gonna attack. I'll kill his Pride Mage because I'll have to plow it anyway at some point. And it's just better to do it now, and I do have to notice that the key's playing burn, so I'll probably want a plus 2 Jace right off the bat. I was gonna have to get rid of the Pride Mage anyway, because I can't really use Stoneforge Mystic effectively, and it's an attacker he'd have against Jace next turn. And I can only block one creature, so if he played another creature and tried to attack Jace, that would pretty much wreck me. No, I'm gonna keep the mental mist up for if he tries to chain lightning Jace or something. The fact that he didn't play a creature is a pretty good sign that Jace is gonna live. So I can act. What are the chances that he has something with haste? No, I'm just gonna brainstorm with Jace, because that just seems like the better play. This is tough. Well, Daze is going on top, and I think I want to keep the click. But I do want... Well, I'll put the Curse Catcher. I'm going to draw it anyway. And it's not like I could play anything this turn. So, let's see. Oh, he actually has some non-basics. Ooh, is he flashing something out here? Oh, he's going to... Oh, man, I didn't even think about Lightning Helix. That was dumb. That was pretty bad. He got me. That was pretty sick. This point, I'm just gonna use Curse Catcher, and I will click him. Actually, wow, that's actually awesome for me. Score. I'll take that any day of the week. Sweet. Probably sure, like, I could have gotten an island there. And... Oh, shoot. That was dumb. Let me see what's in his hand. And then maybe I'll pay the 2 life and mental mist up. He's trying to hit me with both of them. So I'd go down to... Yeah, saving one life isn't really worth it. Yeah, because they're both at me. So I'd go down to 8. Not worried. Like, I can deal with lightning bolts. And since I got the land, I can waste land without worry. I'm gonna go down to 8, but I know to keep mental misstep up. So I'm pretty sure I've got this one. And... Do I want to play Jace or Curse Catcher here? So I'd have to pay 2 life to stop the lightning bolts, but whatever he lightning bolts isn't really that big an issue. I'm gonna fate seal him though to make sure. Nope, don't care. He's just gonna get a land. And I'm pretty sure I'm way ahead in this race. He's gonna have a plateau. It's just keeping the lightning bolts. Gonna fate seal him again. I don't care, I'll have flyers. So that's not a concern either. Now I got a bunch of hawks, which is super sweet. It's like bam! And this is why hawk is better than visions or stencil. Like, I'm actually just gonna straight up race him because there's nothing he can do. Don't need to use the ability. Beginning of combat. And at most he's gonna do, like, I can just fate seal him and make sure he does it. I could always keep a hawk back to block the pride mage and he's dead in two turns. He's pretty much locked and hawk is gonna be it. I mean, I don't even have to worry about anything. Like, he doesn't even have haste, guys, so it doesn't concern me at all. Hawks. Nope. Just in case he does something like kill one of the hawks. I don't care. Oop. And it's gonna take 5. Because he can't stop. Boom. Oh look, I'm alive. I'll block. Won't matter. Like, there's no way I'm losing here anyway, but it's just bad habit if I take the damage for no reason. Please, Mikado, ooh. I got flyers, dude. Your 3-3 doesn't matter to me. Not gonna play with Stoneforge. There's just no need. And game. Gonna cast. Don't daze me, bro. Bam. Okay, so these creatures. He looks to be a very low cost version. Paths are actually going to be pretty good. Dazes aren't really going to be worth it. Curse Catcher, while pretty effective, just probably won't do the job. If I bring in Chalice, I could Chalice for 1, but if he Pride Mages this, and that stinks. It's kind of a... Okay, so far we saw Grim Lavamancer Bolts, so Blue Elemental Blast might be worth it, but it only really stops his spells in... Meddling Mage could name Lightning Bolt, Chain Lightning. It's probably better to take the risk with Chalice than not. And I took out quite a few blue cards. Force of Will is probably not going to be worth much. Okay, so if I bring in Pithy Needle, I pretty much just name Pride Mage. Yeah, I think that's the only thing I would have to name. So I don't know how good that is. I could Meddling Mage. This is a bit annoying. Do you want to keep in a force? But Might just be better to bring in meddling mages. Haven't really tested the match up too much. I want Jace. I can bounce his creatures, they don't have haste. And so I'll try this. Got lots of removal, I can name bolts and stuff. I can give him targets for a Pride Mage other than my equipment, so yeah, seems good.